Well, welcome to Wild West Crypto Show's Country Mile. I'm Brent Bates. Drew is in transit, coming back from the Metroplex, having spent a couple days up at our sponsor, Carnomaly. Put your car on the blockchain, and actually they're coming up with the ability to buy with crypto some vehicles through the car app. So anyway, need to check that out, carnomaly.io. Tell you what, kind of a wild ride today. Let's go ahead and get started on the financials here. Bitcoin's right at 19,000, flirting a little below, flirting a little above, which, you know, puts it right up there near that all-time high that it had at 20,000. And, you know, that's a good-looking chart, way outside of its trend channel. You know, a lot of people are saying that part of the reason this is running is because PayPal is buying up all the inventory with those people that have the ability with their PayPal app to go ahead and buy Bitcoin, and they're doing so, soaking up that little bit of a float that's out there. You do have to think, though, if we find our way back toward that 20,000, that you're going to start to find some supply at some point. You know, there's going to be some people that got in earlier in the year at 3 or 4, and just that kind of a return is enough that causes them to want to do something about it. But another contributing factor is the amount of Bitcoin that is locked up in a DeFi situation. And so with you take hodlers, you take institutions that didn't get in here for just a few thousand points, you take a constant barrage of people buying it through PayPal and other apps that are letting them buy $50 here, $100 here, so on and so forth. Next thing you know, you got a chart that looks like this. And to be quite honest, if it breaks through that 20,000, there's really nothing to stop it going higher. Let's go back and look at the overall market. The overall market is higher than Bitcoin. It's up 4.06, 4.35, bouncing around. But the altcoins are running finely, and that's important for the overall health of the market. The Dow, you know, still has not filled that gap, but now we're starting to follow with the a green candle on back of that red candle. And so you have to kind of wonder what's going up with all of that as well. Still think that filling that gap's got to be in its future. There's going to be things that are going to go back and bring the Dow back down. But it's up 454 today. The S&P's up 57. Again, nice looking chart for it as well. And then you got the tech-heavy NASDAQ that's up 166. Interestingly enough, gold is off. It's off $30 today, 31 right now, at 1805. And there again, you can see it's had a really nice move starting back in April. Digesting this move, you got to kind of wonder how much more downside it's really got before it'll start to base out and turn around. Same thing with silver. It's down 1.5%, down 35 cents, 23.21. Look at my oil buddies. West Texas Intermediate crude, 44.70. That's up $1.87. So isn't it interesting? God's money, gold and silver, is in a little bit of a sell-off while Bitcoin's running, the stock market's running, and oil's running. Can you spell schizophrenia? Because that's kind of what we got going on in the market. Go back and look at that December 21. It's at 1900. It's bounced up and away. And if you go back, it's at 19.9. The overall market's at 19,000. So it's below that 1,000. Premium that it's been putting on the market. So you got to kind of wonder if things are going to start to slow down a little bit here. I'm going to turn the screen a little bit sideways, and I'm going to go over and jump into one of my news sources that I like to follow. And so, interestingly enough, the number two item on this is DeFi industry ponders strategy as regulators begin to circle. You know, we all have been talking about how popular DeFi has become because it gives you the ability to unlock some of the value in your cryptocurrency by providing the purchasing power of that to be used in other projects and in financing. So it's a $14 billion industry. In fact, when you go in and look at the actual article, it talks about the fact that it's a $14 billion industry. And basically, the feds cannot ignore a $14 billion industry. So what they're basically saying is that their defense is they're going to try and self-regulate and see if they can kind of keep all of the regulators at bay. Obviously, the landscape will embrace a certain amount of regulation because it gives them a certain amount of credibility out there for institutional investors. So, interesting things that you find in the news. You go down looking through some of the others. Binance is having some wranglings with its U.S. Account holders. Polkadot, Monero, Dogecoin price analysis. And in fact, if we go back here and look at the actual pricing of coins, you can see there's all kinds of green going to pop up here. Ethereum, 602, XRP's up 19% today. Tether's the only thing that's off, and it's off 0.03%. And just a bunch of green and some huge numbers. Look at Stellar and some others. So overall, the market's not a bad place to be here in the world of crypto, to say the least. You know, you got to wonder, though, what is going to be the outcome of the election? And right now, you got a whole lot of people saying, Trump, throw in the towel for the benefit of the country. And then you got a lot of people that don't like getting their vote scammed saying, go the distance. We need to open up the swamp on all of this. I have a feeling whichever way this ends up falling is going to have a lot to do with what your money's worth and what your crypto's worth afterwards. Well, we've done the 6-minute run. We'll be back with you tomorrow at 3:30 here on the Wild West Crypto Show's Country Mile. Y'all have a great day.